Hello, dear skimmians, DTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start and let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that according to CoinGecko, Bitcoin is trading at the level of $10,077. So it's been trading almost sideways for the last 24 hours. The same holds for Ethereum. Its price is at the level of $189. And we see that the price trajectory is very similar or has been very similar for the last 24 hours if we have a look at the other major cryptocurrencies. So that's why today I just want to talk a little bit about Steam. So Steam, according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko, is trading at the level of 19 cents 0.2306 at the moment, and it is a slight rebound if compared with the prices that we had 2 or 3 days ago. We saw levels close to 16 cents, to 16 and a half cents, 17 cents. So it's a small but positive rebound. But today I want to mention that CoinGecko has been doing really a great job. They have been on Steam blockchain as well, and they have supported our Steam blockchain ecosystem a lot. And I just want to mention that you can have a look at the site of CoinGecko, and you can see at the top of the site that they published this announcement about the Steam Hard Fork 21. Steam network upgrade in approximately 2 days, 6 hours and 35 minutes. So fellas, keep in mind that on August 27, the Hard Fork 21 should take place. So we have to be prepared psychologically as Steamians. Nothing, we don't have anything to do. But I just want to let you know that I will include this link to their explanation what the Steam Hard Fork 21 is about. So if we click on this link here, this is the great post or summary that CoinGecko has published, and this is explanation about the hard fork. So for example, what is the Steam Hard Fork 21? It will take place on August 27 at 15 o'clock UTS time. What changes are coming to Steam after Hard Fork 21? So these are actually the biggest changes, the main changes. So let me outline them. An on-chain decentralized autonomous organization will be introduced as a form of Steam proposal systems. Users on Steam blockchain will be able to submit proposal for funding and vote on proposal that they are funded. A governance system like this strive to make the Steam blockchain more inclusive. There will be change to economics of Steam reward distribution, mainly post payouts. Now factor in the distribution of votes. This encourages stakeholders to distribute their votes to more content. Good news for curators, as the curation reward will increase from 25% to 50%. A separate download pool allows users to download posts and comments without affecting their voting power. And of course, make sure to check if the witnesses you have voted for have upgraded to version 0.210. CoinGecko is a witness node on Steam, and we're committed to upgrading our node seamlessly. So I will include the link to this beautiful post that explains just briefly in a few words the most important aspects of Hard Fork 21 that will take place in a few days. So fellas, let's hope that this will be something beneficial to Steam blockchain. Now let's move to some other interesting news, important news about the Steam blockchain. And I want to talk a little bit about the Steam Fest that will take place in Bangkok in November, at the very beginning of November. So these are the dates. Get your Steam Fest tickets. So fellas, keep in mind that these are the prices for the Steam Fest tickets. It's on the site of steamfest.com. This is the cheapest ticket for planktons. The next one is for minnows. This is the regular price, and etc. I just want to let you know that these are the current prices. But according to a post that was published last month by Roiland, who is the main organizer of this Steam Fest event, He wrote in his previous post that there will be a constant increase of the prices of the tickets to Steamfest. For example, tickets at these prices are available till Friday 30th of August. Then for the next, let's say, 4 weeks, we will have a 20% of cost price increase by 27th of September. Then another increase, and slowly on a, let's say, regular basis, the price will be slowly increasing. The price will be increasing up to the very beginning of the Steamfest that will take place once again in the first half of November. So keep in mind, fellas, that as soon as you buy a ticket, the lower the price will be. So probably I will buy a ticket in the next few hours or tomorrow, because I want to get this good deal. So now, once again, I want to say that today I want to talk about Steam blockchain, but let's move to some interesting news that were published a couple of days ago, actually, on the site of Binance. Binance is one of the biggest crypto exchanges in the world. They have their own blog. So sometimes you can find really very interesting information in their blog. So 2 days ago, they published this post: Binance research on new tokenization report. Too early to rule out blockchains competing with Ethereum. So we know that Ethereum is a blockchain on the top of which we can build another tokens, and this is a platform for smart contracts, and there are many competing platforms, such as Tron, for example, such as NEO, such as Binance Chain as well. And that's why Binance decided to conduct this research and to publish their post. So let's have a look at their post. So this is actually their post. This is the world of tokenization. If you click on this link, it will take you to this post. So what I want to say is, I would like to mention, to comment on some interesting statistics within this post. Of course, they talk about the tokenization standard on Ethereum. That's Ethereum is still the greatest blockchain for token launches, and their standards are ERC20, ERC-223, 777, 721, and etc. And here are really some tables with interesting statistics I want to comment on. So blockchains and main layers supporting tokens. So of course the leader is Ethereum, but we have, for example, some other interesting additional blockchains, for example, Binance Chain, EOS, Omnitron, Cardano, Tezos, NEO, Ethereum, NEM, Ontology, and of course, Steam blockchain as well. So we see that at the moment, the token support is constructed on Steam blockchain. The same holds for Ethereum. These are here the standard names: ERC20, ERC20, 223, ERC721. If we have a look at Steam blockchain, we see that the standard is SRC20, fungible Steam Engine sidechain. So these are the Steam Engine tokens. So this is actually the site of Steam Engine. So that's really great. That's really great that Binance included Steam blockchain and some important statistics into their report. And for example, you can have a look at the token status about Ethereum. It's active, so people, developers, they can launch their own tokens built on the top of Ethereum blockchain. The same hold for Binance, the same hold for EOS, but it's not the same for all of the blockchains. For example, if we have a look at Bitum, it is in the phase of development. Straits, active but not used. For example, Nulls, active but not used. But if we have a look at Steam blockchain, it's active. And I'm really very happy to see that Steam blockchain and this opportunity to build additional sidechains or tokens on the top of Steam blockchain is active is really some great news. And that's why in the next table, we can see a comparison of activity and developers between chains. So this is Ethereum, native asset ETH, Genesis block, July 30, 2015. And at the moment on the top of Ethereum blockchain, there are more than 200,000 tokens. So there are a lot of GitHub comments. There are a lot of transactions performed on the Ethereum blockchain. So they have 200,000, more than 200,000 tokens. But that's why scalability issue is a big problem, a very big problem for Ethereum limitations. As of today, one of the main issues with Ethereum relates to the scalability of its base layer, which sometimes results in high gas fees and slow transactions. So, as I have mentioned in my earlier videos and market overviews, most of the major cryptocurrencies such as Ethereum, as Bitcoin and etc., they have faced the scalability issue, and that's why additional tokens or competing, let's say, platform for smart contracts were able to pop up, for example, such as EOS, Tron, and etc., and all these blockchains that I'm commenting at the moment. But what I want to say is, because we talk about the activity on these blockchains, I want to mention that, for example, if we have a look at Binance chain, that is very promoted and famous blockchain because of the cryptocurrency exchange Binance, they have a little bit more than 130 tokens. EOS has 4,200 tokens. So it's much, much less than if compared to Ethereum. Tron has 2,800 tokens, or a little bit more, built on the top of Tron blockchain. NEO has 120. Ontology has 15 tokens. IOST has 80 tokens. Steam is doing quite well. Steam is doing quite well because it has over 490 tokens, and those are actually at the moment the tokens built on the top of Steam blockchain via Steam engine. So if we click on the site on Steam engines, these are the tokens. We have a lot of tokens, so it seems that we have almost 500 tokens built via Steam blockchain on the top of. So this is the list of these tokens, and I'm really very happy to see that Steam has more tokens built within its block, within its ecosystem, if compared to NEO, if compared to Ontology and the other famous blockchains. Because I remember in 2017, in 2018, people used to claim that NEO, Ontology, they were going to be something great. But nowadays we see that Steam is much greater there than this blockchain. But unfortunately, I'm a little bit surprised that such experts, such as people working for Binance, they don't understand the difference between Steemit and Steam, and they always write blockchain Steemit. We know that Steemit is one of the first applications, or the first blogging application built on the top of Steam blockchain, but it's Steemit is a different thing from Steam. And the expert of Binance, they have they wrote Steemit everywhere in their tables. For example, comparison of issuance fee, Steemit, not Steam blockchain. The same holds and for the other tables. For example, median daily volume on DApps, so decentralized application, Steemit. Once again, they should have written Steam. So that's not the point. I think that very soon, much more people, including the researchers, analysts of working for Binance, will realize what the difference between Steemit and Steam is. But at least I'm very happy to see that the activity on Steam blockchain is relatively high. We have a lot of tokens. We have a very high average daily transactions, let's say volume, for example, 913,000 7-day average daily transactions are performed or conducted on Steam blockchain. So this is very sim this is even a little bit harder if compared to these numbers relating to Ethereum, more than the number of transactions performed on Binance chains. Of course, we see that EOS and Tron, they have 3.5 million. So only these two blockchains, according to this table, have a little bit more transactions on a daily basis if compared to Steam blockchain. For example, we see that Ontology has just 23,000 and 0.4 transactions per day. NEO has 14.6 transactions. So I'm really very happy when I see such great numbers, because this is really a great really great achievements for Steam blockchain. So fellas, that's it for today. Once again, don't forget to buy a cheap ticket for the Steam Fest, and I wish you a wonderful Saturday, a Sunday. Enjoy the weekend, and hope to see you in my next video. That was me at CryptoSpark.